Way back at the very beginning of Yu-Gi-Oh, we had Maneater Bug, one of Yu-Gi-Oh's very first effect monsters, and it was a great card. Then, eventually, a few years later, we got Noble Maneater Bug, which was technically an upgrade in effect, but realistically, no one really used this card. It wasn't really worth tribute setting a level 5 monster if it only had 1200 defense, even if it did have an effect that could destroy two monsters instead of one. Then, many years later, in modern Yu-Gi-Oh! We got Crawler Spine, which pretty much is a strictly better version of Maneater Bug. It is a level 2 insect flip monster that does have the flip effect to target one monster and destroy it, but has way better stats and a bonus ability if you are playing a crawler deck. Obviously, we got plenty of cards that mimic the original Maneater Bug effect over time, like Snow Maneater and Shadal Squamata, but I consider Crawler Spine a lot closer to the original Maneater Bug because it is a level 2 earth type insect monster. Recently, Konami has upgraded a ton of older school monsters, so it was really only a matter of time before we got a new version of Maneater Bug. In today's video, I wanted to look at this new card and kind of talk about what it does, but then I also want to talk about what it takes to really push these older cards if you want them to be playable in modern Yu-Gi-Oh! But first, let me tell you about today's sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by Ridge Wallets. If you're sick of your older, bulky, outdated leather wallet, then you should look into Ridge Wallets. They're sleek, they're industrial, they come in all sorts of styles and colors, they can hold up to 12 cards, and they have a convenient money clip on the back for carrying cash. If you guys are interested in checking out Ridge Wallets, make sure to click the link in the description below or go to ridge.com/DZeef and use promo code DZeef for 10% off of your order. Thank you to Ridge Wallets for sponsoring today's video. Mimetizing Maneater Bug will release in Burst of Destiny in the OCG in just a few weeks, but we won't see this card for quite a while. This is the core set after Dawn of Majesty, and Dawn of Majesty releases in August of this year, so you'll be waiting a while for your new Maneater Bug card. This card is a level 4 Earth Insect Flip Effect monster with 450 attack and 600 defense, and it has two different effects. The first effect says flip, target one monster on the field, destroy it, and if you do, this card gains attack equal to that monster's original attack. Then you can make this card's type become the same as the destroyed monster's original type. The second effect says this card on the field cannot be destroyed by battle and cannot be destroyed by the effects of monsters with the same type. Now if you're like me, you might look at this card and ask yourself, why does Maneater Bug have a type stealing effect? That doesn't really make a lot of sense. Well, on the Yu-Gi-Oh! News TCG tweet that this graphic is from, someone replied and said that Maneater Bug was incorrectly printed as a warrior type monster in an older OCG Yu-Gi deck, and that might be why this Maneater Bug can steal a card's type. That might be a throwback to a very old misprint in an OCG deck. But how good is mimetizing Maneater Bug? This card is a considerable upgrade from the original Maneater Bug printed so many years ago, but just because a card is better than an older card doesn't make it good in modern Yu-Gi-Oh! And I think that might be the case here. While this card is pretty good compared to Maneater Bug or many other Maneater Bug clones that we've had over the years, I don't think it's good enough to see any sort of competitive play. It'll be pretty funny when it works though. I mean, you get to pop a card and then it puts a protection effect on the mimetizing Maneater Bug, and it potentially can gain a lot of attack points, but in reality, I think it's going to be way too slow in any modern Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel, probably even on a casual level. And that sort of brings the question to my mind, how good does an older school upgrade have to be to see play? I think Konami did a good job with this new Maneater Bug, but as the recent Penguin support has shown us, it can be pretty darn difficult to make these older flip effect monsters relevant in modern Yu-Gi-Oh! Really think about how much Konami has given the Penguin archetype over the years. They have so many cards that on paper are very good, and yet it's probably not going to be competitive even with the new support. And Maneater Bug is obviously a lot worse off than Penguin Soldier because it doesn't have all of the support that Penguins have gotten over the years. This new Maneater Bug might have been good in the past if it was released a long time ago, but compared to even casual decks nowadays, is I just don't think this card is going to hold up. Now, this might surprise some of you, but I don't really think that every single new card needs to be competitive. It is perfectly okay to have cards like this that are mainly for casual fans, but it would have been pretty cool if a Maneater Bug upgrade would have been good enough to see modern play. Now, I'm not really sure how they would have done that. It's pretty difficult making one single flip effect monster good enough to see play in 2021, but they maybe could have given it a few more effects to really push a new version of Maneater Bug. I guess the question would be, do you, as a player, as a fan of Yu-Gi-Oh, prefer retrains that are like Pharaonic Guardian Sphinx, which are upgrades from the original versions but not quite competitively viable, or do you prefer cards like Millennium Eyes Restrict, which is an upgrade from Thousand Eyes in many ways but was pushed far enough to be competitively viable, but also it's a pretty fun card if you wanted to play a more casual deck based around Relinquished. Now, there are many examples in both of these categories, and there's plenty of cards that fall somewhere in between, but this new Maneater Bug is pretty clearly on the Pharaonic Guardian Sphinx side, where it's not really meant to be competitively viable, and it'll probably never see play at tournaments anytime in the future unless it gets some more crazy support. But like I mentioned with the Penguin support, it would take a lot for a card like Maneater Bug, even this new version, to see play in modern Yu-Gi-Oh! Yeah, Shadal Squamata sees play, and that is a flip effect monster that has an effect that's basically Maneater Bug, but that's not really why people play that card. They play it for the other effect. The flip effect on that card is kind of just a bonus. So, what do you guys think about this new mimetizing Maneater Bug? Do you wish Konami pushed it to be even better, or are you okay with how it currently is? Clearly, Konami is all about upgrading older school cards right now. We have seen a ton of retrains over the past few months especially, so I don't know why exactly they're doing this. Obviously, everyone loves these old cards, and it's cool seeing them get upgraded forms, but I think they really could push these cards a little bit more if they wanted people to get a chance to play them at competitive events. Still, I am a big fan of this new Maneater Bug card, even if it's not going to see any competitive play, and I hope to see more retrains for cards like this in the future. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about this new card. I'll see you later. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.